mechanical project development starts with the designing. So first you have to design the system in a software or on paper, and after that you can start the fabrication. If you create or fabricate a system without the designing, there is no guarantee it will work as intended. So there are many softwares available to do the designing, including SolidWorks, AutoCAD, and even other softwares like FreeCAD. So whichever software you use, the GUI is different, but the process or the working remains the same. So there are 2D as well as 3D softwares available. So first you have to create the design of the system or the mechanism that you are making. And after that, you can go ahead for fabrication. So whichever tool you use, you just need to create a design first, and then you can proceed to the fabrication of the system. So now we will study the project parts, their fabrication, and the assembly of the project. So now let's first access the project diagram and components. For that, you will need to access neonprojects.com. So once you access the website, just scroll down through the search bar, and there just type the project name. So this is the project here, as you can see. You can also download the project document and synopsis, also the PPT of the project here for free. So now let's scroll down to the project block diagram. So as you can see, this is the block diagram, and this is the a block explanation of the working of the system. So here you have a flywheel which is to be manually rotated, and it is connected to a sprocket through a chain based arrangement. And when you spin the flywheel, the sprocket turns the other rollers on the other side, and this is the screw here. When you rotate the screw, it presses down the third roller, which helps you achieve the bending angle. And this is the side view of the system, as you can see when you spin the flywheel, and the more you press the screw, the more the screw presses downwards, the third roller it presses down, and this helps you achieve the kind of angle you need for bending. So it's a variable bending machine, so depending on how much you spin the screw, it presses down and you get that particular angle. So the more you press, the less the radius you get in the bending. So these are the parts here, but before that we'll see the developed version of the system. So as you can see, these are the chain sprocket arrangement. This is the flywheel on this other side of the machine, and this is the screw here. So when you press the screw, it presses the third roller downwards, and based on that, when the rollers rotate, you get the bending as per the angle you specify. So now let's view individual parts of the system. As you can see, here is the chain sprocket. You can just click on it. So these are the chain and sprockets. These are the parts you can get online. You can get the sprocket as well as chain here. So one thing you need to keep in mind is the pitch. Okay, if you buy a sprocket for a certain pitch, the chain also should be of that particular pitch. If you buy a half inch one pitch, then the chain also should be of the same the length of the chain will depend on the distance that you keep between the rollers. So as you customize the system, and if you want to customize the system, you can change the distance, and based on that distance you have to calculate the amount of chain that would be required. And the other parts that are required are the flywheel, the bending rollers, the bearings, and the joints and screws and mounts. So the rollers are to be made on a lathe machine, and this is a screw. The screw is fitted with a rod, so you can spin it as needed. And this is the base frame construction of the system, and it's all these are angles, and this is a sheet metal work. So if you don't have knowledge about all these components and fabrication and assembly, so you can just click on order now and order the kit, and you can make it yourself at home. You can get all the parts here which you know are not able to make at home, and you can just assemble it yourself and also check the design and get entire knowledge of the system development and working. So now let's move on to the next part, which is the testing and working of the system.